This chapter will introduce the effect of the hull's surface on fuel consumption. A standard anti-fouling paint requires yearly docking, but newer self-polishing paints can still be effective after a longer period of time. Experience shows that data collected from different speed logs give different average speeds. The best way to find the accurate speed is to use a measured mile landmark. The distance should be covered in both directions and averaged, in order to eliminate any effect of eventual current or tidal stream. In any case, a good and reliable speed log should be an important investment on any vessel. As much as 20% of excess fuel consumption can be traced to bad hull conditions, extreme surface roughness, and overgrown propellers. A hull is subject to many kinds of irregularities, such as flaking paint, bumps in the plates, corrosion, welded edges, etc. Its roughness is calculated as the average difference between the lower and higher micrometer reading over a distance of 50 millimeters. The average roughness of the entire hull is then averaged over many such readings. These are done with a special instrument when the ship is dry docked. It assesses if a hull should be sandblasted or a propeller polished. Hull roughness measurements are recommended both before and after the hull is coated. The roughness of the bow and other critical parts of the hull will have more influence than less critical parts on the global performance. Marine growth will vary, depending upon the paint types used, the waters sailed in, the time of the year, and the period of stay in harbour. It will start with a slimy surface and develop to seaweeds and later to barnacles. While dense seaweed may increase the surface drag by up to 40%, a dense growth of barnacles may very well double this. Better hull maintenance will reduce roughness, marine growth, and save fuel consumption. Maintenance costs will vary with its frequency and the technique used. Studies show that a speed loss of about 0.5 knots will rapidly justify a hull maintenance, such as hull scrubbing or dry docking. The latter calls for a thorough cleaning, possibly partial sandblasting and reconditioning. Ships on polar routes may suffer from ice contact. These will require a yearly docking and hull painting. Since marine growth in temperate climates is worst in summer, docking at springtime would be the best choice. Autumn will then call for a good hull inspection.